In this session, we are going to talk about an incredibly popular tool that Nerdio has to offer, the Nerdio Cost Estimator. We know that one of the biggest challenges MSPs face in building a cloud practice in Microsoft Azure is deeply understanding the cost of purchasing Azure from their distributor, or in some cases directly from Microsoft. MSPs are concerned that in moving to a consumption-based selling model, that they may accidentally quote their customers an incorrect or unrealistic price for Azure services. The Nerdio Cost Estimator aims to solve this challenge by providing MSPs with an easy-to-use tool that has considered all of the pricing challenges one may encounter when quoting Azure deals to their customers. In this session, we will walk you through the Cost Estimator, looking at a common use case, desktop as a service, where the customer wants to leverage Azure for a simple virtual desktop environment for a small organization. Enjoy the session.
The next use case we'll look at is the desktop as a service. This is more about a situation where you have a company that wants to stand up an office that has virtual desktops in it instead of putting physical desktops for that office. There's going to be no line of business servers, no application, no database servers in this deployment, but it's going to be a bit more flexible in terms of what type of users you can have. So you can see once I select desktop as a service, I now have the option for both VDI users and for GPU users. So we can say, all right, let's go with a 25 user deployment here, and let's say five of them are going to get dedicated virtual desktops as VDI, and then let's say none of them are going to have graphic needs. We can also include Office 365 in this particular case, so let's say 25 for that. Let's say yes for reselling RDS. We can select, let's say, no to Azure hybrid usage because this is for a small environment. It's unlikely that the customer already has that. The partner can obviously purchase it through software subscription, but let's just say no. Let's also say 1 year to the reserved instances. We're going to do in-region backup. We're going to do no DR. And we are going to have hybrid AD. Now, why do you need hybrid AD? Because we're not putting any applications or data in this environment. We're just putting the desktops. So they have to connect back to their data somewhere, right? That may be their data and applications may all be SaaS-based and not require any VPNs or connectivity back to a corporate environment. But in this case, let's assume that there is an existing corporate environment with some applications that are going to be accessible through VPN. So we're going to enable hybrid AD and have VPN selected as yes as well. And in this case, let's say we're not going to use RDS collections. In every case before, we looked at RDS collections as yes. In this case, because it's only 25 users, we can get away without the additional complexity of having a connection broker and having a scale set. We can scale things slightly differently. Now, the next question is around auto-scaling, and you'll recall it's disabled right now because reserved instances are set to 1 year, but let's play this out with reserved instances set to no, meaning we're going to be paying for things doing pay-as-you-go. So we're going to go to pay-as-you-go, we're going to do desktop auto-scale yes, and then once we have desktop auto-scale, then the system asks you, okay, how many users out of those 25 are going to be running 24/7, 12/7, or 8/5. So let's say we're going to have 15 users that are going to be 8/5. We're going to have, you know, five users that are going to be 12/7, and we're going to have our five, you know, VDI type users running it 24/7. Okay, then again, our bandwidth, our storage ops, our CPU core ratio, that is an important metric we need to tweak here because that's going to determine the size of the recommended RDS session host. So let's go really aggressive here and let's say we want two users per core, meaning it's just they have a pretty heavy application load where every two users need their own CPU core. We're not dealing with GPU, so this is going to be disabled. And then we are gonna have to specify the size of the VDI desktop. And given that these are very, very advanced users, we are gonna give them, let's say, a 4-core 16 gig of RAM D-series VM version 3. Okay, keeping our discount at the same level, keeping our Office 365 discount, let's say at 15%, and same region and everything. You can see we don't have the option for on-ramp regions because this is meant for a smaller environment. So that's probably not relevant in that type of an environment. We click view costs and we have our breakdown. So what we see is it's $104 per user on average, right? Because it's a smaller environment with a large percentage of those users having dedicated VDI machines, right? So out of 25, 20% are on VDI. So that adds to the cost. And especially since the VDI machines are pretty beefy with 4 CPUs and 16 gigs of RAM. We're going to have a small amount of file storage for, for things like user profiles and desktops and document redirection. We're going to also include Office 365 E3 licenses. We're going to do backup. We're going to be using no reserved instances, no on-ramp regions. We are going to provide RDS, as a partner. That's what they would do. And desktop autoscale is on and hybrid usage is not enabled. Okay, so here's our environment. We have a modestly sized domain controller, file server, hybrid AD domain controller, a single RD gateway, and then 10 cores worth of RDS session hosts. Now, again, that from a cost perspective, we need 10 cores. In reality, we would probably end up going with, either a single 8-core or a single 16-core or maybe 3-4 cores or something like that, depending on if there is a natural split between the different user groups. If you have a user group that's going to be doing, kind of accounting work and another user group that's going to be doing marketing work, you may give them different session hosts. But if all of them are going to be exactly the same, we may just want to go to a larger VM when we actually go to deploy. And then, as we mentioned, 5 of these machines are going to be VDI desktops, and those are going to be 4-core, 16 gig of RAM VMs. You'll see here we have a monthly price only. We have nothing up front, and that is because we are not purchasing either reservations or software subscriptions to be able to do software Azure hybrid usage. So that's why this number is all per month. This is there's no upfront commitment. You can see that there is a pretty significant number in the desktop compute and storage. There's a small amount of bandwidth. You have some autoscale savings that's right here that basically shows you how much you save by the autoscale settings that are going to shut those machines off or resize them based on the user work hours. So that number offsets this number. You have no DR, server compute for all of those services, 335, etc. So again, if you look at all of that, if you roll it all up, you're up to $104 per user, including all the licensing. Now let's see if we can tweak it a little bit more, make it a little more efficient. We're gonna go 3 years RI and we're gonna go with hybrid usage. Then our cost is going to drop pretty dramatically from $104 to $67. And now you'll see here, we have an upfront component and we have a monthly component as well. And on average, obviously this number dropped too. So desktop autoscale savings goes away, but the total desktop cost is much lower. And the reason it's much lower is because we're using these 3-year reserved instances that provide more savings than doing of the autoscaling itself. Okay, if we kind of mix and match, if we say no to this, but yes to Azure hybrid usage, then we're taking this number up quite a bit